here with me in the studio, and then I'll open it to everyone else.
It's, of course, the way your reporter has said that it's an unprecedented, and I believe that this night is going to be long, and we are going to watch this political drama happening over there. See, BJP ne apna tan, man, dhan aur gan sabka istemal kiya hai is election ko jeetne ke liye. Abhi kam se kam कांग्रेस ने अपना जो
ऐसे बोल रहे जैसे कांग्रेस ने किया ही ना,
कांग्रेस ने अपना जो प्रोटेस्ट दर्ज किया है वो वैलिड है और उसको वो कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल है, उसको इलेक्शन कमीशन को कंसीडर करना चाहिए और उसके हिसाब से अगर जजमेंट में कांग्रेस हारती है या जीतती है जो भी होता है वो सामने आना चाहिए, मगर उनका प्रोटेस्ट वैलिड है क्योंकि जो जिस तरीके से दो एमएलए ने अपने पेपर अमित शाह जी को दिखाए हैं, जो भी दिखाया है, जो वीडियो में रिकॉर्डेड है, तो वो अगर ना दिखाते तो जो शाह जी से उनको जो मिलने वाला था वो ना मिलता।
नहीं, अगर वो दिखाया है आपने देखा वीडियो, दे हैव टू अप योर फेडर नाविका, योर ऑडियो, यू आर नॉट ऑडिबल राइट नाउ। Well, we go across to, we will just go across to Navika. She's through live with us. The moment she's audible, we'll go across to her. The returning officer in Gujarat will declare, and we are getting confirmation that could happen any moment soon. Even though the EC is in a huddle and the joint secretary came down to receive the documents from the Congress party, did not meet with anybody, just took the documents, went back up. But we are given to understand that sources within the Election Commission confirm that the decision will be announced soon. That is the decision on these two MLAs and what will happen, because counting will get underway. We'll get Navika through any moment now. Aman Sinha, you wanted to, in the meantime, respond to Ravi Srivastava, who somehow has seen the video which we have not seen, has seen the video which only the returning officers should be privy to, and some of the people who are part of the nominated, designated as agents who would have been called in should have seen. But he's already decided that the ballots were shown to Mr. Amit Shah, Ms. Smriti Irani, and Mr. Balwant Singh Rajput.
Is, Anand, I'm not lying.
Well, Anand, let me say at the foremost that the legal and constitution position is very, very clear on this. And it has been settled by large number of Supreme Court constitution bench judgments that election process, once started, cannot be stopped or interfered with. And this is what the Congress party is trying to do. It is unprecedented that for the first time, a election process to Rajya Sabha counting has been stopped for more than 5 hours under the pressure of Congress party. This is the unconstitutional act of the Congress party. And let me say that as far as this situation goes, the counting has to resume at the earliest and results have to be declared.
Is there merit in the Congress party calling for the cancellation of these two votes, citing the Kuldeep Nayyar case?
Let me say, the judgment on which Congress party is relying, the Kuldeep Nayyar judgment, it goes entirely against them. I have the text of the judgment, I can read it out here, and it says that if a individual is not voting for a candidate of his own party, he can, the principle of secrecy is not absolute as far as Rajya Sabha election is concerned. This has been settled by large number of Supreme Court judgments, and therefore if a candidate wishes to show, he can show it. He can show the ballot.
So you are not denying the fact that it's possible.
And in fact, Kuldeep Nayyar goes in our favor.
So you are not denying the fact that it's possible that the ballot was shown to all and sundry there. So you are not denying the possibility of the ballot being shown to all and sundry.
Okay. Please allow me to read out the relevant part of the Kuldeep Nayyar judgment. I'll just read it out. That voting MLA may refuse to show his vote to authorize agent, but in such an event, he forfeits his right to vote. There is a vote in favor of any person he thinks appropriate and shows his vote to the authorized agent. The rules do not contemplate cancellation of such vote. It is absolutely crystal clear.
So in that case, why was this rule applied in the case of Randeep Surjewala when he showed it to the CMP MLA Kiran Chaudhary?
No, in fact, the principle in both the cases is same. The principle is that once the returning officer has decided, his decision will be final. and if at all it can be a subject matter of challenge by an election petition and no other way. An election process cannot be stopped or stalled for any rhyme or reason.
So the point is,
there is an express bar that even courts cannot interfere.
Are you making the point that if the decision had to be challenged, it had to be challenged then itself? It had to be challenged at 9:30, 10 o'clock in the morning itself? Is that what you're saying? Alimuddin Khan with us. Let him say.
Allow me to respond.
Yes.
If it had to be challenged, it had to be challenged then and there. And even if they had challenged it and returning officer in his own wisdom has considered and rejected it, then it can only be a subject matter of challenge by way of an election petition.
But the returning officer has neither, returning officer has considered and he has said the returning officer.
Their case is that in fact Anand, they have challenged it after the voting has closed. So therefore, they have no case at all, and the judgments on which they are relying, you know, I'm very sorry to say, they go entirely against them. I do not know what Congress legals are doing.
So this is actually boomeranged on the Congress party. Sab kuch backfire ho gaya, Alimuddin Khan. आप हार रहे थे क्या? आपको पता लग गई, भनक लग गई, क्योंकि काउंटिंग से पहले ये ड्रामा शुरू हुआ, इसलिए मैं पूछ रहा हूं, पोलिंग के बाद और काउंटिंग से पहले?
आनंद जी, आई गिव यू अनदर एग्जांपल ऑफ ईयर 2012 व्हेन सदानंद गौड़ा बिकेम चीफ मिनिस्टर, ही वाज कॉन्टेस्टिंग एमएलसी इलेक्शन, वन एमएलए देयर सो हिज वोट and his vote why that vote
Rajya Sabha chunavon ki baat kare, rules of engagement are different for Rajya Sabha,
president of the election commission itself.
Rules of engagement are different for the Rajya Sabha, aap bhi jante hain, main bhi janta hu, to dekhiye, apples and oranges comparison nahi karenge, let's not waste time on the debate.
Then it is the final decision. This is what the act stipulates and this is what large number of judgments of
you please tell me.
You cannot differentiate,
sir. This is
what do you mean by differentiating? The returning officer has taken a view. If you are aggrieved by it, you go and challenge it in an election petition.
Okay.
How can you stop the election process?
Now,
it is unprecedented. Never in this country, election process has been stalled and counting has been stalled for such a long time.
Now, please, this is, I've got number 39. That is the rule. I'm reading this out to our other panelists also. Because ye technicality pe humko ghuma rahe tab se. 5 hours ho gaye, counting nahi hua. Ek Rajya Sabha seat thi, which the Congress party said it is just a Rajya Sabha seat. Don't please call him the political secretary of Sonia Gandhi. He's just a Congress party member. But unke liye 44 MLAs ko Bangalore mein bithaya, fir Anand mein bithaya, resort ke paas. And then today, look at the tamasha. Look at the political heavyweights who have come out from both the BJP and the Congress party. Ladies and gentlemen, this is no ordinary Rajya Sabha seat and there is a lot attached to it. This is about prestige. This is about ego. Sir, this is, I have with me, Section 39, maintenance of secrecy of voting by electors within a polling station and voting procedure. Every, and they say, the elector on receiving the ballot paper shall forthwith.
Aman Bhai Patel is going to win this election. It is matter of.
अगर इतना है तो counting होने देते. इतना है तो counting होने देते. Sir, this one. Sir, here.
Of the country is hijacked by the BJP.
Yes, Suman Sri Raman and Nawab Malik.
Constitution to exercise its powers. They are not allowing even.
Anand,
they are
two things.
Entire
two
cabinet
things.
Sitting in the election Anand, commission. Have you seen in your
what
life?
What do you mean by this? Why is the Congress party, why did the Congress party, foremost went to election commission with a prayer to stall the election process and stop counting? Do you not know the elementary law that once the election process has started, it cannot be interfered with or stopped or stalled for any rhyme or reason? Why did you indulge into such rampant and blatant unconstitutional practice? And therefore, if BJP delegation is going, just to state what the clear legal position is and not to, destroy and diminish our long-held constitutional principles and norms.
Suman Sri Raman, come in, sir.
Congress party is using everything, but still they are not able to retain their floor.
Whatever.
In our respective
states,
and you are now trying to.
I think the Congress party should seriously introspect if they cannot get through the political.
Yes, Suman Sri Raman. Okay. Now I'm going to ask the Congress and the BJP already.
Of Congress party and its own members.
Sir, ye kahin pe bhi ladne ka mauka nahi chhodte hain. Yahan thoda ruk jaiye. Let the other panelists speak. Aman Sinha and Alimuddin Khan, please wait.
Like a pack of cards.
Yes, Suman Sri Raman.
Internal contradiction.
Suman Sri Raman. Mr. Nawab Malik has not spoken. Juhi Singh.
Anand, while one second, Mr. Sinha, 1 minute. One minute. Yeah, I think Anand, tonight may be a long night, but this issue is not going to be settled tonight. Hmm. This is almost certainly going to go to the court, irrespective of what the Election Commission decides now. Hmm. The losing side is going to take this to the court. So I don't think we're going to see a conclusion. What may happen is that the Election Commission may give a decision. Based on that, the counting may happen and the results may be declared. But this is going to go to the court. And another little bit of information, which one of the journalists has tweeted out, apparently, and the irony of ironies, D.K. Shivakumar, who hosted the Congress MLAs in Karnataka, says that his vote was also cancelled during the last Rajya Sabha election from Karnataka for a similar reason. Yeah. So this is a very interesting tidbit which is connecting D.K. Shivakumar to what is happening here.
D.K. Shivakumar is connected to a lot of things which is happening in the Congress party, but that will go there. They'll take the debate sideways. But D.K. Shivakumar to Randeep Surjewala, they are feeling the pinch and the pain. That's why they're coming out there. They're leading delegations because their vote was rescinded, sir. But that was the returning officer's call, and perhaps the objection was taken as and when the ballot was cast. Here, the polling is over, counting is about to begin. Look at the sequence of events, and that is important to consider. Mr. Nawab Malik.
For everything to
Mr. Nawab Malik.
Yes, but
please.
Mr. Nawab Malik, Mr. Nawab Malik, Khazab, rukiye. Khazab, rukiye, please. Alimuddin Khan, aapke paas, there is a significant amount of delay. So please, whenever you hear me, please stop. I have to open it up to other panelists. Unko bolne ka mauka dein. Yes, Nawab Malik.
You can play important role in this. Please,
See, Anand, I want to tell the audience that before 99, there was a horse trading in the country during the Rajya Sabha poll. Then the anti-defection law was stringent. Open ballot system has been adopted. After that, in the country, this all trading, horse trading, were stopped. Why this drama is happening? Because the Bharatiya Janata Party was not having enough number to contest the 3 seat. There were 2 clear-cut seat, and third one, they are relying on the horse trading and defection. The law was changed. The entire BJP was advocating in the era of Atal Bihari Vajpayee. They want to stop the horse trading. They want to stop the anti-defection in the political party. Mm. What happening today? In Haryana, same thing has been happened. In Gujarat, same thing is happening. And today, BJP is advocating different thing. Mm. Absolutely, there was a situation where the third candidate not in a position to win the Rajya Sabha seat. And for that, they had given a third candidate.
But the charge against the NCP is that it's the NCP that backstabs, sir.
And therefore, there is so much desperation.
No, but the charge against the NCP, Mr. Nawab Malik, is that NCP ne bhi game khila. Aapke ek vyakti bolte, ek vidhayak bolte ki mujhe to instruction diya tha BJP ko vote do.
Anand.
NCP kehti hai, humne to kaha tha ki Congress ko vote do.
Anand, let me clarify. Let me clarify. Anand, let me clarify, please.
Yes.
Let me clarify. From the very first day, we had given support to Congress party. Hmm. At the time of nomination, our president, Jayant Boski, was with Ahmed Patel. Hmm. And what happened? The Kandal Jadeja said he is not going to vote. What reason he was taking? In 2012, we were having alliance with the Congress party. 9 seats were given to us. 5 of the seats, they had filed nomination on the symbol of Congress party. 4 of seats, they were rebellion. That's why he was hostile. He was not ready to vote for the Congress party. It is true. The whip has been issued today. Boski himself said that he is voted for the Congress party. Hmm. And another vote also, he said, we said him to vote for Congress. If he deny the whip, then action will be taken against him.
But
that's all right. Action can be taken. But the vote cannot become invalid per se.
And just a moment. In last debate, NCP person said the whip was for voting for BJP. Now you say it was voting for Congress. So there is something within NCP of some kind of double play that is going on.
Listen.
Point is, bigger point is, Congress
listen,
are making it a prestige issue.
Say, listen.
Okay, please.
In a parliamentary system, whip is not a verbal. Whip is a written service to the person who is going to vote. That is a whip.
Nobody can dictate verbally to anybody.
Mr. Casta said that I am the official spokesperson and I say we were to vote for BJP. Whether you are official or Casta is official, that is a big question.
Nawab Malik, Mr. Nawab Malik is the boss of all the official spokespersons at the NCP. So if Mr. Nawab Malik is saying here on the news are
on the same channel,
what stands out?
What stands out?
He's the media cell chief in the NCP. So if he is saying that there was a whip was issued to give it to the Congress, that's the exact point, Mr. Nawab Malik. What we are saying. कि एनसीपी के अंदर ही कंफ्यूजन है कि आप कांग्रेस को सपोर्ट कर रहे थे कि बीजेपी को या आपने कहा चलो 50-50
एमएलए की क्या गलती है
नॉट कंफ्यूजन वी हैड इशूड अ व्हिप व्हिच इज अ रिटन व्हिप बट मिस्टर कांदल जडेजा वाज नॉट एग्री टू ओड मिस्टर अहमद पटेल बिकॉज अ कैंडिडेट वाज फाइल्ड अगेंस्ट हिम इन 2012 ही सेड व्हेन अ कांग्रेस पीपल डिच मी Why should I vote for him?
Personal
this is what the situation.
Correct. So,
we want to convince him. Mr. Parfun Patel himself went to the Gujarat. In evening, he talked to him and a written whip was issued to
so it, of the in agency. In a way, jis tarah se paase gire, it was very convenient, Mr. Nawab Malik. Because what happened is net now in the books of the Congress and the BJP, there was one vote from the NCP which went to both. So it is like 50-50. हमने आपकी भी मदद की, हमने आपकी भी मदद की. This is politically very convenient. Yeah. You spread your risk. That's what you've done.
But with due respect,
Mr.
If
yeah.
Okay. Let me make another point.
Yes.
Well, let us not be after NCP. Poor chaps. Okay. Just two seats. Point is that Congress by putting all its prestige, all its resources on one Rajya Sabha seat. By ditching the people at the time of the flood, they have spoiled their chance of the assembly election. They could have easily sacrificed a small Rajya Sabha seat, gone ahead and made a moral stand against BJP in Gujarat and made a much stronger pitch for the assembly election just 1 year away. But by not doing so, they have shown that much more rights on Ahmed Patel than what is so apparent.
No, but so
is it because Sonia's future?
Also?
Is it about... No, for them it's a third
no,
seat.
Sir.
It's a mischief. See, for them, it's a sweet revenge. No, sir.
Kind
no, sir.
Of money
for them,
the kind of
for, that is what you are saying. Is there any
was,
proof who offered what?
Both of you.
Sir, I am not talking of BJP. I am just talking of purely political analysis that this is what has gone wrong with Congress.
RSS moral first. Don't give sermon to Congress. See,
I am giving
sermon.
Advice. Who am I to give sermon?
You
have a problem. For Sonia Gandhi, you cannot ditch Ahmed Patel. So there is something more riding on Ahmed Patel than what you suspect.
What moral do you have?
So you are exposing yourself by going downhill by taking a late action. You expose yourself. You should have acted much earlier. When Waghela was thrown out, when Waghela went away, at that time Congress didn't wake up.
Now, here is one thing.
Congress
yeah.
More than
yeah.
you. Congress have. Congress have.
Juhi Singh coming to you and Zafar Sareshwala after this. Yes.
Congress have experience of 125 years.
One BJP was
Congress does not need your advice.
Waghela can be manipulated. And my dear friend, Waghela cannot be manipulated. Waghela is so such a sharp customer who could break the BJP way back in Khajuria case when Congress helped him. You cannot really manipulate Waghela. He's too beyond that.
No. See, I'll tell you what.
You could not control Waghela. That is the truth.
Alimuddin Khan, ab pachta hai kya ho jab chidiya chuk gayi khet. Ab aapko pata tha ki Waghela ji naraaz ho jayenge. अब हमको पता लगा है कि अहमद पटेल साहब तो रेडी थे कि भाई मैं 5 बार राज्यसभा में आ चुका हूं, मुझे जरूरत नहीं है. आप वो इतने पावरफुल है कांग्रेस में, उनको क्या जरूरत थी. बट जुई
राज्यसभा,
दिस इज नॉट अ स्मॉल सीट.
Yes.
This is not a small seat.
Remember,
because this is an excerpt from Mr. Sanjay Baru's book, Accidental Prime Minister, where it says, on a daily and regular basis, messages between Sonia and the Prime Minister were conveyed either by Ahmed Patel or Pulok Chatterjee.
Sir,
while Pulok met Sonia regularly to brief her on policy issues and seek her guidance on key decisions, Ahmed Patel was a political link between Sonia and Dr. Singh. Ahmed Patel would visit South Block mainly to lobby with Pulok for inclusion of names of Congress party members on the boards of public enterprises and nationalized banks. So this man is no small fry. This man is a big man, and that is why it made him such an issue of prestige.
Ahmed Patel is a parrot whose life is very important for the Queen.
And that's the reason why, that's the reason why they have put all their might, muscle and everything behind this one seat. And what you're seeing today is because unko bhanak lag gayi ya kahin se ye pata lag gaya ki perhaps he might not win it. Because if they were confident of winning, irrespective of what the BJP did, like they said in the afternoon with Ashok Gehlot and Arjun Motwadia, they should have allowed counting to happen.
Yes.
Why this 5-hour delay?
Anand, once the election process starts, then I don't think legally it can be stopped. At the right moment to protest was in front of the returning officer, and his decision was final. And of course, I mean, this one seat has become more important than the national elections of India, because I can see our both the cabinet which was earlier, and the cabinet which was there as an election commission, and the election commission we are certainly giving a lot of work to do. But I agree with Aman Sinha, because it has to come through an election petition, and I really don't understand why so much prestige was attached to this one seat, and nobody can blame the other party for not strategizing, because both parties were strategizing and strategizing very effectively and efficiently. So
ye lo Alimuddin Khan,
high moral
Alimuddin Khan, ye to ek aur ally phisal ke haath se. NCP, NCP,
NCP,
जदयू बिहार में जदयू निकल गई, अभी यहाँ पे NCP 50-50 हो गए, अब समाजवादी पार्टी कह रही है ये देखो क्या किया आपने,
देखिए आनंद जी,
जफर सरेश वाला, this is the whole comedy of errors, and the biggest pawn in this is the Congress party, which loses at all costs, at all levels in Gujarat and also at the center.
चलो जफर साहब को सुनते हैं क्या कहते हैं गुजरात के बारे में.
Anand, the issue is not whether the things have gone to election commission or it will go to Supreme Court. As somebody said, the losing side will go right up to the Supreme Court. That is not the issue. The issue is the defeat of Congress party is going to be the beginning of the decimation of Congress party at its worst. I mean, it's not an ordinary election. Mr. Ahmed Patel, right from Mrs. Indira Gandhi to Rajiv Gandhi to Sonia Gandhi, he's been the most important person in the country. And the last 10 years of UPA, even the finance minister and the home minister of UPA did not have direct access with the president of Congress party. Most of the ministers had to go to the president via Mr. Ahmed Patel. And you quoted Sanjay Baru's book. It is absolutely, it's an open secret. So the defeat of Ahmed Patel, it is actually the defeat of the leadership of the Congress party.
No, and sir, no.
The worst thing
I have strong
was,
objections on
the worst thing.
On this, no. It is merely a Raj Sabha seat.
Just let me complete.
Being fought in Gujarat,
sir. Alimuddin Sahab, let me complete.
It is elected Bharat Singh Solanki versus Amit Shah. Now you continue, sir.
No. Let me complete. Bharat Singh Solanki is a non-fry. Nobody knows him even in Gujarat. Alimuddin Saab, kisi ne unka naam tak nahi suna. Madhav Singh Solanki saab ko jante hain. Ye Bharat Singh Solanki kaun hai, kisi ko pata bhi nahi hai. So, aap please, mat boliye. Lekin main aapko ek baat batata hoon.
Main
aapko ek baat batata hoon.
Kaun hai, aapko nahi pata.
Arre, ye sab, ye bichare, inki, ye Modwadia aur ye sab jo hai, inki koi haisiyat nahi hai. Ahmed Patel saab ke saamne ye khade bhi nahi reh sakte. इनकी कोई हैसियत नहीं, हमको पूछो ना.
अहमद पटेल साहब को आप कह रहे हो, अहमद पटेल साहब को कह रहे हो कि उनको मास बेस्ड लीडर नहीं है, और वो इतने 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 बड़े लीडर भी हैं, इतने छोटे
नहीं. अहमद पटेल साहब,
सर,
अहमद पटेल साहब,
ऑन स्टेटमेंट सर.
नो, अहमद पटेल साहब की वफादारी सिर्फ गांधी फैमिली के साथ है, वो इंपॉर्टेंस है उनकी. उनकी वफादारी और किसी के साथ नहीं है. 40 साल की उनकी वफादारी गांधी फैमिली की है. और वो नहीं, गांधी फैमिली, गांधी फैमिली, सोनिया गांधी, राहुल गांधी, राजीव गांधी, सोनिया, इंदिरा गांधी. आप सुनिए, आप मेरी बात खत्म होने दीजिए. बहुत बड़ी गलती जो आपने की, आपकी जहां पर पकड़ थी सेंट्रल गुजरात में साबरकांठा और बनासकांठा, जहां पर सबसे ज्यादा फ्लड्स हुए थे, आपके एमएलए को आपको वहां रखने के बजाय आप उनको बेंगलोर लेकर चले गए। मैं समझता हूं कि इतनी बड़ी हिमाकत शायद ही कोई सियासी पार्टी कर सकती है कि हर वक्त किसी भी गमजदा का जो फर्स्ट पोर्ट ऑफ कॉल जो होता है वो उसका एमएलए होता है, लेकिन आप उनको लेकर बेंगलोर चले गए।
चीफ मिनिस्टर
तो आपने क्या किया? अरे अरे आप अपने यानी आप सोचिए कि आप अपने एमएलए को जब नहीं संभाल सकते तो आप स्टेट को कैसे संभालेंगे?
कांग्रेस उपाध्यक्ष आए वहां पर दौरे पर
व्हेन यू कैन नॉट कीप द 44 कंट्रोल द स्टेट
बीजेपी क्योंकि राजा आए थे रंग तो थे नहीं
When political culture
and you know what sevak to the
defeat of Ahmed Patel the defeat of Ahmed Patel is like
the reality is Nalin Mehta as Zafar Sareshwala says it Zafar Sareshwala this is what happens when you have a person on ground who has seen it from close quarters comes on the news hour and says it this is the character Zafar Sareshwala he's just saying it out I've got another passage to read allow me this as I come to you Nalin Sanjay Baru's book again on one occasion Ahmed Patel arrived at 7 Racecourse Road just minutes before the Prime Minister's letter to the President listing the names of MPs to be sworn in as ministers in a reshuffle was dispatched. The letter had been typed, signed, was ready to be delivered and the President was waiting to receive it. So they decided instead of wasting time and retyping the letter, जो नया नाम Mr. Ahmed Patel सुझा रहे हैं, they will just write it and the other name will be wiped out with a whitener. This is the level to which this is the influence Mr. Ahmed Patel wielded in UPA 1 and 2. And that is the reason why we are seeing what is unfolding so far. Over the last 15 days, since the 28th of July till now, 10 days, actually, 10 days, 10 to 12 days. Let's get it, if the numbers here and there, give a day or two here and there. But we are seeing the might and muscle of the Congress party unleashed because of this one man and his proximity to we know who, Nalin Mehta.
Anand, there is no question about the importance of Ahmed Patel in the Congress's hierarchy and why this battle is such a big, is such a make or break for Sonia Gandhi, because the question will be asked, if Ahmed Patel loses, and the Congress has been insisting since the morning that they have the numbers, if he loses, the question will be asked to Sonia Gandhi that you couldn't even get your political secretary re-elected from Rajya Sabha from Gujarat in the Rajya Sabha from a relatively safe seat. So in that sense, this is about the moral authority of Sonia Gandhi within the Congress party. It's about and the BJP knows this, and this is why the stakes for the Congress also are much higher than what they are for the BJP in this case.
If he wins, then that will be a defeat of Amit Shah.
Fine.
That will defeat of
absolutely. I am not saying that he's winning or losing. I am saying that you've been. I am saying if he loses, I'm talking about the politics of it. If he loses, that's why the stakes for the Congress are so high.
If he wins, then will it be a defeat of the
Narendra Modi? If he wins, the Congress lives to fight another day. Congress lives to fight another day because then they'll have to turn their attention to one Mr. Jairam Ramesh who says you're facing an existential crisis, not an electoral one.
I think what
force... Yeh aisa hai. You're fighting at so many corners. Aaj yahan jeet ke kal wahan ladai karni padegi. You're fighting at so many corners.
This is about... This is a prestige battle about the Gujarat...
You've plugged one of the holes in a sinking ship, sir. That's the reality. The hard fact.
If somebody so senior in the Congress is not re-elected, it calls into question the winnability of the Gandhi's across the board. That's why it's so important.
Anand, yes, the Congress party is falling like a pack of cards because of its own internal contradictions and because of its weak leadership. And therefore, you know, these internal contradictions are leading to such collapse and decimation of Congress party all over.
Abhi counting
instead of learning a lesson or two, they are trying to go on preaching BJP about constitutional and
Aman Sinha, counting is not yet over.
That and what if, they are doing
if,
is
if Mr.
totally
Ahmed
against
Patel
the
secures
constitutional
a seat,
principles. They are trying to stop and stall an election process, Anand.
Aapko itna to manna padega. Aapko thodi to haar manni padegi. Thoda to khatta to lagega aapko. If Mr. Ahmed Patel wins this, then you will also have to concede.
Anand.
Ki bhai jeet gaye, ye wala haar gaye hum. Ye baat hi haar gaye.
That he would lose. And he, Anand, even if he wins, in such a safe seat, if BJP has given such a tough fight, this also is a moral victory for BJP.
We are counting down literally to decision.
counting down literally to the decision, the poll panel decision, in a very, very short while from now, we are given to understand. I also have Editor-in-Chief Rahul Shivshankar walking in to join us on the News Hour, because the results will come out anytime soon. The returning officer is going to decide. Returning officer is going to make his decision, and we will get to know it here on Times Now. And the result will be any time soon. Rahul is just getting mic'd up right to my right. And even as he does that, we just go across. Suman C. Raman wanted to make a point. Yes, Suman C. Raman.
Anand, one quick point. Yeah. Anand, I think a lot of this issue is probably that the Congress was forced into this fight once the BJP raised the stakes, because they knew that Mr. Vaghela and there was dissonance was going on for more than 1 year. So this is not that on the eve of the Rajya Sabha election, they figured out that there would be people who would cross vote. They knew this well in advance. Their hand was forced because of the assembly elections in 4 months' time. They couldn't be seen to be running away from a fight. Otherwise, it would have been possible to just pull Mr. Patel out, have him elected from some other state and sent to the Rajya Sabha. The point was, with 4 months to go for the assembly election, you can't seem to be backing away from a fight. Mr. Vaghela leaves the party, you face huge amount of dissidence there, and on top of that, such an important person like the political secretary to the Congress president, you can't even get him elected, you have to withdraw him from the fight. That would have been a loss of face for the Congress party.
Let's ask Alimuddin Khan this.
Forced into this fight.
At what point in time?
Primarily because of the assembly election.
No. Rahul Shivshankar, Editor-in-Chief, all mic'd up and ready to join in on the debate, on News Hour as we count the election, countdown to the decision.
You know, Anand, let's just cut to the chase.
Yes.
Now is that time when Sonia Gandhi's prestige is going to be evaluated, counted literally, vote by vote, not by me, not by you, not by any of our panelists, but by the returning officer of the Election Commission. He holds Sonia Gandhi's prestige in his hands. And he is going to basically pass judgment today on the eroding fortunes of the Congress party if, of course, the Congress party loses. Now, there is a lot of speculation, Anand, and then I would like you to take us through the numbers. The Congress says that they have accounted for every vote. And according to their calculations, they have 43 from their own Congress MLAs and 2 from cross voters. So how is the Bharatiya Janata Party, and I'm just injecting an element of suspense here, how is the Bharatiya Janata Party saying that it's winning this one? Because we spoke to two of those so-called NCP and JDU cross-voting MLAs. They say they haven't really cross-voted. They've actually voted for the Congress. So how does this change?
Well, that's what I was about to ask Mr. Alimuddin Khan, because if the based on this, the Congress should have said, let the counting happen.
Yes.
And the BJP would have been the one which have had to defend the fact that they lost against Ahmed Patel despite putting all the might and muscle of the BJP, including the party president Amit Shah.
And those, the numbers are there on our screens.
57 dropped down, resigned 6, defected 7. So the number falls to 44, cross-voting 1. That was confirmed even by Arjun Mudwadia. Earlier, Ashok Gehlot also said that. So it came down to 43. The backing of NCP, the 50-50, and also backing of JDU makes it 45 for Ahmed Patel. I was about to ask Mr. Alimuddin Khan, why did the Congress decide to protest then? But this is an update coming in as Managing Editor Politics Navika Kumar also joins us on the broadcast. We can expect the Election Commission order by 11:30 p.m. and that the JDU has sacked the Gujarat Unit Chief Arun Srivastava. Two developments that have happened as a fallout of the JDU split vote also. Navika.
Well, it's very clear that the Election Commission is going to be giving its decision in just a few minutes from now. That's what I've been given to understand. It should be any time now. And the returning officer in Gandhinagar Counting Center will announce that decision, because that's the norm that the Election Commission is going to be following. It's going to be coming in from the Election Commission officer in Gandhinagar. It's not going to be a decision that's going to be announced from here in Delhi. That's what we are being given to understand. Decision anytime shortly.
But and Navika, after why that, would the counting JDU will take begin. This action? If the JDU was certain that its writ was really followed, then why would it be taking this action? And This would only suggest that perhaps the Congress is in the ascendant here, because if the JDU MLA has indeed defied the writ and voted for the Congress, then those numbers begin to stack up in its favor.
There's confusion in every camp. There's confusion in the NCP camp. There's confusion in the JDU camp, where the JDU MLA says he's voted for the Congress, but the JDU centrally says that it has given a diktat for voting for the BJP. There's complete confusion. But the numbers that I'm getting, Rahul, and let me take our viewers through those numbers, we are given to understand that Amit Shah will get 47 votes, Smriti Irani 46 votes, Balwant Singh Rajput 40 votes, Ahmed Patel 43 votes, and the extra votes from both Smriti Irani and Amit Shah will go to Balwant Singh Rajput, which will take his count to 45, which means the three candidates. That's the estimation coming in from certain sources that we've been speaking to. That's the estimate in the BJP circles.
Which obviously raises the question. If the BJP is so confident, and I want to open this out. Let's open this out. Let me go across to Nalin Mehta. Nalin, this would mean that from tonight, Sonia's writ over the Congress party itself will begin to wane. Because if Sonia Gandhi cannot get her own man, her own pick elected, then the fortunes of the party under her are not guaranteed.
But then is it guaranteed by Rahul?
One second. Let's take it step by step.
This is exactly why the stakes are so high in this election, Rahul. This is exactly why the Congress has pulled in everything into winning this. I mean, taking the MLAs to Bangalore. This is the last time this happened in Gujarat was in 1995. And ironically, at that time, Shankar Singh Wagela led it, but Narendra Modi tasted defeat because he was a proxy chief minister at that point of time. This time, if the Modi Shah combined, they are on the winning side now, yes. The question will be asked of Sonia Gandhi that you can't get Ahmed Patel.
Which obviously brings us to the second point that Mr. Ratan Sharda was sort of going to expand upon, which is
about the internal power structure.
Does this also then reflect on brand Gandhi? That's the fundamental question, Mr. Ratan Sharda.
Yeah, see, because I am very doubtful.
Will Rahul's own ascendancy be affected?
It's not just Rahul. Was absent from the meeting.
In this kind of battle, Rahul, we have the heavyweights of the BJP and the Congress fighting it out in the election commission. The question should also be asked, where is Rahul Gandhi? I mean, I know there's a report that he's out because of a viral infection, so he's been sitting out. But the bottom line is, this is also about the internal transfer of power from Sonia to Rahul. Sonia's own winnability, continuing winnability.
And that will get affected, Mr.
Alimuddin Khan, that's the question many people are asking tonight. Alimuddin Khan, where is Rahul Gandhi in all of this? After all, it's only a viral infection. Why if Chidambaram, if Anand Sharma, if Ghulam Nabi Azad, if all of them can come out, why can't Rahul Gandhi? It's only a viral fever, and this is the battle.
Well, live pictures of Amit Shah on our screens. He's awaiting obviously that result, and you can see him there sitting there at the counting booth. Now, it's very, very important. All the principals are absent from the Congress. Neither is the individual who's contesting this election, on the back of whom there is so much speculation, so much drama, which is Ahmed Patel, not there, not present.
See, Amit Shah's guts, he's sitting there knowing whether he will win or not, very sure. But he's there to face. No Congress leader is ready to face the scenario. That is the difference.
Well, Mr. Alimuddin Khan, there you go. Does the Congress desert not just its own, but also its fortunes?
What is the arithmetic that you did between 4 o'clock and 5 o'clock? Hame bhi bata dijiye.
You see, election has been conducted and irregularities has been done. Two MLAs has shown to the three people that we have...
Why did you realize this after polling?
And that is the clear...
Why did you realize this after counting was over and before... After polling was over, before counting was about to begin?
Decision of the election commission. We hope that election commission will use it...
Okay, the chief minister is going to be addressing... Let's cut across. The chief minister of Gujarat. Listen in. We've lost that signal. It seems to have been an older bite which was being refed. The point is, and let's forget, you know, who started this. Let's forget who started this war challenging the EC. Let's focus now on the outcomes, because that's really where the story is going to be. And I want to go across to Mr. Sureshwala. Mr. Zafar Sureshwala. Mr. Sureshwala, it's black and white tonight. There's only going to be one winner. The BJP says it's going to be us. Where does this leave the Congress party in the state you originate from? What do you predict for it?
You know, Rahul, unless and until Congress party does not go in deep introspection, I don't think any positivity can come up. You know, where they've gone from in 85, 149 to 55, and from 55 to 44, and that is also a question mark. Now the issue is that when you cannot control your 55, you have to take them to Bangalore. The question in the ordinary people's mind is that how can you control a state when you cannot control your own people? And then if Mr. Ahmed Patel loses, then it goes directly to the doorstep of the president of Congress party, that when you cannot assure Ravi the Shivastava, most important the point, person after it? You.
The Gandhis are becoming a liability.
Most important person after you.
They are eating and cannibalizing their own political party.
What is going to happen?
Congress had been on a roller coaster, I think, for last 3 years. Now, this is perhaps they are going to touch the bottom or something like that. And the words Sureshwala has used, the introspection. I don't think that introspection can happen in Congress unless the leadership goes for a radical change. Because we were listening to the MLAs of Gujarat also in the morning, and many were saying that we had quit the party because we were not, Mr. Rahul Gandhi was not listening to us.
Has Dynasty become a liability for the Congress?
Serious problem.
Is Dynasty also going to become a liability in the days ahead for the Samajwadi party? Is this a lesson for you to draw from?
Yeah,
I agree. Rahul, one point.
One minute. Let's get Juhi Singh to respond.
To the people explaining. We have already thought about it. We are going to the people from tomorrow onwards. We are supposed to be on the roads. We are supposed to organizationally rebuild ourselves, and that's what we are doing. Whether it's the membership drive or whether it's the tomorrow's big Andolan, which we are organizing at every district headquarters. But I mean, this is a Rajya Sabha election, and I would say that putting so much prestige behind one seat is something which every party would need to really think about. So Samajwadi party is doing exactly what it is supposed to do.
Navika Kumar, I think, you know, Navika, the point is, I think all these political parties in the opposition are not seeing the writing for what it is. That the BJP, if it wins this, is the party that is expanding its footprint at the cost of others. That should worry them. That should worry them, Navika. Fundamentally.
Well, it's very clear. Very clear. The BJP has surpassed the Congress's tally in the Rajya Sabha with two more BJP, Amit Shah and Smriti Irani being elected. That gap will even widen. And if Balwant Singh Rajput also wins and Ahmed Patel is trounced, then clearly, the message is that the BJP is playing for winning, whereas the Congress only fights for Ahmed Patel, and even then, it loses. So, therefore, it's an extremely important battle as far as the BJP's future is concerned. But even more, the Congress party is staring at the writing on the wall. And what happens to the opposition unity on the floor of the House? Well, remember, Navika, in Rajya Sabha, Sitaram Yechuri is gone. He's no longer there cementing the opposition ranks together. There are very few opposition parties left in the Rajya Sabha as well. And that is something all opposition parties really need to think about, Aman Sinha.
Well, I just want to bring in Nawab Malik and Zafar Sureshwala, who wanted to raise a point.
BJP is in its best ever
Aman
position.
Sinha, yeah, okay.
We are the largest party in Rajya Sabha today.
You know, right from the 1950 onwards, Congress was the biggest party in Rajya Sabha. Today, we have become the largest party in Rajya Sabha. We are obviously the biggest party in Lok Sabha. We have maximum number of MLAs, maximum number of state governments. We are in our all-time best position. And similarly,
yet you are so
Congress
desperate
party,
about this one seat victory.
No, we obviously on back of the blessings that we have from people and even from the
this has nothing to do with people.
They are
this
all.
Is-
They
this
are
is,
all they are all elected representatives. They vote for Rajya Sabha members. The point that I'm
is
making is that
power.
We are at our all-time best and Congress is at its all-time low, Navika. This is the point that you were making. And look at the, you know, the contrast between Congress and BJP. BJP President Amit Shah is there at the counting center, leading from the front. And Congress party, you know, everybody has deserted and run
Nawab
away.
Malik,
they ran
Nawab
away
Malik,
during Gujarat floods
this,
also.
Is this the
and
sign
now this
of
tsunami is sweeping
what we've
them,
seen in Gujarat today? Mr. Nawab Malik, is this...
What do you mean by Sam Dam Dand Bhed? You have run away. You have run away and run away.
You have done Alimuddin Khan. 44 MLAs ko Eagleton Resort mein theraya. Wo kya tha?
By force.
Aapne kya kiya?
No.
Aap to band karke rakhe hue the.
Values.
MLAs, you are a good one to explain democratic values, Mr. Alimuddin Khan. What
okay,
was
we'll come back to this. We'll just come back to this. We need to take a very short break. We'll come back to this. It's heating up here. Results out anytime soon. We are being told in the next 20 minutes we'll have something for you. But we are back in just 2 minutes.